أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
whoever is deprived of his reward is the real Sanctifying One. Dear brothers and sisters, this month is the month of generosity. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was most generous, and he used to be more generous, even more generous during the month of Ramadan. And therefore, I chose to address a topic that is relevant to our wealth and the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon our wealth, because it seems there is a phenomenon of lack of awareness concerning this aspect of Islam. Dear brothers and sisters, zakah is one of the pillars of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who legislates all the rules and regulations of Islam, and therefore whatever we have is from Al-Hakim Al-Aleem, the one who is all-wise and all-knowing. And therefore, we don't expect but the best serving for the greater good from the rules and regulations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, this divine system is based on pillars. One of these pillars is zakah, which is the financial obligation that is upon every person who meets the requirements of the zakah. If we do not understand and realize the importance of the zakah, then there is a major flaw in the setup of our community and the setup of our community and the Muslims in general, because it is these flaws in understanding the basics which is causing us to be in a condition that all of us are aware of. Dear brothers and sisters, there are severe warnings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against those people who withhold the zakah and don't pay it to the poor people. By the way, this is the right of the poor people, meaning when the wealthy people and affluent people give this zakah, they don't do the poor a favor. Rather, it is a right that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has informed us about in the wealth of the rich people due to the poor people. There are, as I was saying, there are a lot of severe warning against those people who withhold this zakah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, says in the Quran, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ بِمَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ هُوَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ بَلْ هُوَ شَرٌّ لَهُمْ سَيُطَوَّقُونَ مَا بَخِلُوا بِهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَلِلَّهِ مِيرَاثُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Let not those who withhold that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them out of His bounty ever think that this is better for them, or that this is worse for them. Their necks will be encircled on the day of judgment by that which they withheld. Their necks will be encircled. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam further explained this ayah by saying that those who do not give the zakah of their money will be encircled by the most vicious, the most poisonous types of snake that will encircle their necks and tighten their grip on them throughout the day of judgment that lasts for 50,000 years, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decree whether their destiny will be to the hellfire or to paradise. So this is a very severe warning. And at the end of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِلَّهِ مِيرَاثُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs the heritage of all what is in the heavens and all what is on earth. To remind us that even though we are required to pay this zakah, but Allah does not benefit from it. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is self-sufficient and in no need of our money. We spend for the sake of our own selves, for the sake of our own salvation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Hakim, the All-Wise, He legislated this pillar for the service of the greater good of the Muslim community and people in general. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةَ وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَهَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ يَوْمَ يُحْمَى عَلَيْهَا فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ فتقوى بها جباههم وجنوبهم وظهورهم هذا ما كنستم لأنفسكم فذوقوا ما كنتم تكنزون. Those who hoard the gold and the silver and don't spend it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give them the tidings of a painful and severe torment on a day when it will be heated in the hell fire, and then their foreheads and their flanks and their backs will be branded with this gold and silver that they hoarded. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end said, "هذا ما كنستم لأنفسكم." This is what you hoarded for yourselves, so taste what you hoarded. So this is the treasure that you hoarded, so taste it. And Rasulullah further explained this, as Bukhari and Muslim recorded, that on the day of judgment, this wealth, or the gold and silver that is stored, that is saved, and no zakah was paid on it, will be turned into a place of fire that will be put on the chests of those people who did not pay the zakat and merge into their backs. And it will be put on their backs and merge into their chests. And any time that it cools down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be heated again, so that people will taste the punishment. This is a very severe warning again, and this is going to take place during the day of judgment that lasts 50,000 years. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam also warned us against withholding the zakah that is due to the poor. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said a very beautiful hadith that shows the consequences of sin, that لم تظهر الفاحشة في خوم قط حتى يعلم بها إلا فشى فيهم الأوجاع التي لم تكن في أسلافهم ولم يمنع ولم يمنع لم تظهر الفاحشة في خوم حتى يعلم بها إلا فشى فيهم الأوجاع التي لم تكن في أسلافهم ولم يمنع الميزان ولم يمنع الزكاة إلا منع القطرة من السماء. And this is the point from the whole hadith, is that when people hold and withhold the zakat that is due to the poor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the sky to uphold to abstain from rain. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ولولا البهاء من المنطقة. And had it not been for the sake of their cattle, it would never rain. This is a severe warning. Dear brothers and sisters, imagine the positive impact if all the Muslims in the United States pay the zakah of their wealth. Can you imagine? And I'm saying this, and I chose this subject because I see a very very weak revenue for the zakat in this masjid. Throughout the year, we had a balance of almost 2,000. The demand for the zakat is a lot more than the zakat that is available for the poor. And I know we can do better. And I know it is a matter is in lack of awareness, lack of education, lack of understanding, or this significant pillar of Islam. Dear brothers and sisters, just to take an example to show you the impact, the positive impact that this may have on our community. Take one segment of our community. That is the segment of the doctors. And the doctors, by the way, are not the richest of our community. They are well off, alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. but they are riches. However, let's take their this segment according to the Islamic Medical Association. There are it has 18,000 doctors registered with this organization, and this does not include all the doctors that are in the United States. But if we are to take a very conservative guess that of every doctor having a $500,000 of taxable, of zakatable, I'm sorry, zakatable money, this these doctors will generate around $225 million annually, and this is one segment of our community, and it is not the richest segment. I know some tire shop owners who make more money than doctors. So we have a lot of rich people. They have people who, alhamdulillah, they were successful in establishing businesses and even empires here in the United States. However, what is important is to know that there is a right for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our wealth. We cannot tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you don't have business in our business. That okay, I'm going to pray and pray tarawih and wake up for suhoor and be good in Ramadan, but don't come close to my wealth. There are a lot of people who separate in their mind between their business and between the obligations of Islam. They think this anything when it comes to business goes. And this is a problem. And this is something that Rasulullah has predicted. He said that a time will come when people don't care where they get their money from halal or haram sources. Dear brothers and sisters, if our hearts are able to speak, do you think, do you know what they will say? Dear brothers, I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if our hearts are to speak, they will cry. They will cry, they will shout loudly that we are in need of nourishment, in need of things that makes us healthy. Why I can swear on this? Because this is the nature of the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the heart in such a way that the only thing that can make it whole and healthy and clear and pure is the spiritual nourishment that comes in the form of righteous works. One of the best ways to nurture these hearts and supply them with a healthy source of nourishment is zakah, is paying the zakah. And I'm not saying this from my own, rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا. Take from their wealth a charity by means of which you cleanse them and cause them to grow in purity. So when somebody gives zakah, this cleanses himself and from many of faults of this self, and many impurities like stinginess and greediness. Okay, so if we are to listen to our hearts are in need for this, because nothing can make our heart in its best condition like the ata'at, like al-ibadat. And one of these ta'at, as I said, is spending in the way of Allah. So this soul will grow and become bigger and bigger and purer and more noble in the sight of Allah, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves this soul. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the person, then what is more to attain? I mean, is there anything that is beyond attaining the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is something that is very it should be the goal of every one of us. This is how we should measure our accomplishments. Many times people brag about their accomplishment, but the standard we use is the wrong standard. It is the worldly standard, but the true standard is how many accomplishments we achieve from the Akhirah standard, from the standards that make us in higher status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give you one example about a true achievement, a true accomplishment by one of the companions who lived in Islam only for 6 years. That is Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, he said Sa'd ibn Mu'adh in Al-Ansar is like Abu Bakr in Al-Muhajirin, which means he is the best of Al-Ansar. And when Sa'd ibn Mu'adh died, اهتز عرش الرحمن لموته, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trembled to receive his soul. Out of pleasure, trembled out of pleasure to save his soul. Because if someone is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will command everything to love him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the inhabitants of the earth and the inhabitants of the heaven to love him. And what an accomplishment better than to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You brothers and sisters, this is the arena in which we should race with one another and fight with one another, because whatever we accumulate from this world is going to remain in this world. We only take with us what is done purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidi al-Mursaleen wa Imam al-Muttaqeen Muhammadin Abdullah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Beloved Muslims, dear brothers and sisters, allow me to share this story with you. A story about a person who is very affluent, very rich. He owns properties, rental properties, malls, gas stations. He is multi-millionaire. One time he confided in me, and he is from not this community, so that you don't try to think and speculate and put something in your mind. He is not from this community. He confided in me, he said, and he started crying, started weeping like a child. He said, Sheikh, I want to tell you something. I said, what is it? He comes to the masjid, prays with us. He's graduate from Sharia. He said, Sheikh, I cannot pay the zakat of my money. I cannot. Someone who has millions, is not that he doesn't have the cash so that he can pay for the zakat of his money, but he cannot. He is so stingy. And this is the problem, dear brothers and sisters, because there is no limit when we start racing in this world in order to accumulate more and more of this world. There is no limit. If you start calculating, you will calculate until you weigh the value of every cent you have. And if you are before choices, you say, oh, if I do this, then it will grow. You're thinking about how this cent, why should you give it away? And the alternative, if you don't give it away, you can investment here and here. You can get a loan against it also, and even though you have 10 million, you can operate on the level of someone who is having $100 million. What do you think about that, dear brothers? This is illness, dear brothers and sisters. And Therefore, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, As-sadaqatu burhan. When you give a charity, this is a proof of your iman. Because you are giving away, trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trusting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة مئة حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. The example of those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like a seed which grows seven spikes. In every spike there is 100 grains. That is, يعني every cent that's multiplied by 700 times. But not this only. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاللَّهُ يُضَعْفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah will multiply further for whomever He wants. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that a deed can become, by the multiplication of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as big in reward as a mountain. A deed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it and give it give special care and cause it to grow until the person will come on the day of resurrection and find it like a mountain, which means the charity can multiply by millions of times. What prevents us from spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Fear of poverty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ. Whatever you spend in the way of Allah, Allah will replace it. What prevent us from spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Fear about the future of our children. Wallahi, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best guarantee for the future of our children is our own righteousness. And this can be established and happen by spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the logic of the righteous people. Like that righteous person who said, اِدَّخَرْتُ مَالِي لِنَفْسِي عِنْدَ رَبِّي وَادَّخَرْتُ رَبِّي لِأَبْنَانِ. I have just left all my money. I saved all my money. I kept all my money with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for my own self. So I get the reward for my own self. And I left Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for my children. Because if we are righteous, and remember, وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the reasoning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has employed two prophets in order to erect that wall that was hiding a treasure for two orphans. The story that is mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf, that the reason behind this protection and preserving for the children after the death of their parents, the reason is وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. Because their father was a righteous person. Allah is there, dear brothers. And those who spend in the way of Allah, they do because they know Allah is there, and they trust Allah. They trust the promises of Allah. They trust the promises of Rasulullah. They trust when Rasulullah made an oath. ثَلَاثٌ أُقْسِمُ عَلَيْهِمْ. He said, I made an oath by Allah that the wealth will never be decreased by spending a charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never. Rather, it is one of the causes of rizq and sustenance and more sustenance and causing whatever we have to grow from material point of view and from reward point of view. Blessing. If we don't spend, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not purify our wealth. Spending purifies and cleanses our wealth and cleanses our souls and make us more righteous in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, now I'm going to end. But I'm going to end with a warning. Not because I like to scare you. Not because I like to be hard on you. Because I feel that there is an obligation upon me to convey this message to you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam swore by Allah, by Rabbul Ka'bah, three times. He said, هم الأخسرون, هم الأخسرون, هم الأخسرون. He said, they are the losers. They are the losers. They are the losers. In one narration said, and another narration, also in Bukhari and Muslim, like the first one. المكثرون هم المقلون يوم القيامة. The most affluent amongst you are the people who will be in poverty on the day of judgment. People will be in need on the day of judgment. This is the point of this. This is the truth by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Rasulullah makes an exception. He said, except those, and this is a special responsibility upon those people who have the wealth. Except those who spend, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put the four directions. From left, right, front, back. Which means spend abundantly out of their money. Dear brothers, you've been asked today to donate many times during this month. You should never be bothered by this. Rather, you should feel an honor that you have been given a chance to participate, to contribute to another one. And you will be asked to donate more and more. And you should not be troubled. You should be honored to participate in these causes. As you know, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Asma, said, "La tuki fayuka alayki." Do not tighten the string of your money bag, otherwise Allah will tighten the string of His ata to you, His generosity upon you. So those who spend, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not replace it for you? And if Allah is keep giving you more and more, why do you have a problem in giving more and more? In the end, dear brothers and sisters, I would like to just as a disclaimer clarify this, that there is zakatul mal, which is a zakat that has nothing to do with the month of Ramadan. But most of the people spend it in the month of Ramadan, which is fine. There is zakatul fitr, which is a zakat that is owed at the end of Ramadan. And it is upon every member of your household. If you are a family of five, meaning husband and wife and three children, then you have to pay on behalf of five people. There is different range of what you may pay, but I recommend that you pay $10 per person or $8. I mean, the reason of this variation, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given a choice between different types of food that you can donate. If you donate for the masjid, you need to have the intention to authorize the masjid to buy food on your behalf, because this is a special charity that be given, that must be given in the form of basic food. This is the second point. And again, you are asked to donate generously and support the masjid. But zakah has special 8 categories where you can spend the zakah in them. So it is a specific zakah, not a general donation. And therefore you need to keep this in mind. The whole of we have that for Afim al-Salaam.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة